Hi, I'm Matt Shope, Director of Engineering for Conair, and I'd like to spend a few minutes talking about something that I'm really excited about, and that is our new common platform for controls. So why did we do it? Developing this common control platform for our products was a major project for the engineering team and took us the better part of 2 years to complete. But we were getting a lot of feedback from our customers that employee turnover was a major issue, user training, because of the employee turnover, and a lot of these new machines were really hampering them as they built new plants and expanded their lines. As well as, you know, managing these changing technologies is a real challenge for everyone, including ourselves, and moving to a common platform minimizes that risk and effort. And finally, we've heard from a lot of our customers and industry partners that they're ready to embrace Industry 4.0 and they're looking for an easy solution. So when we talk about a common control platform, that really has two major components. We have the HMI design, which is the user interface, and then we have the hardware piece, which is the PLC, the touchscreen itself, and all the associated I/O and communications. So let's first talk about the new HMI. So some of our goals when we were designing the new HMI were we wanted to make it more intuitive for our users across all the product lines. We wanted to have a common user experience to help our customers reduce training time and increase operator efficiency. And we wanted to provide the most important information and settings immediately when the user walks up to a machine. So in order to accomplish that, we worked with an industrial design firm to create a new controls architecture from the ground up. We interviewed customers, we interviewed our salespeople, service, partners, engineering, and all the other key stakeholders that we could identify. After doing that and getting some of those requirements and likes and dislikes, we prototyped many iterations to determine the final HMI design guide that we were going to use moving forward. One of the key pieces of that was we had to adhere to user interface best practices like minimum button size, text size requirements across all the different display sizes. So when you look at the new HMI, some of the common elements that you'll notice immediately are the colors are the same, buttons, graphics, things like the alarms and how the alarms are accessed, the navigation through all the different screens. We have a common place for all the different settings, as complex as something like a smart FLX or as simple as something like a TCU. The navigation is the same. Now, different machines use different screen sizes due to their complexity, but all the elements on the screens are the same. They can be used as interchangeable across all the display sizes, and they will definitely appear the same for the same type of equipment. And then finally, we've had a lot of requests for user access and permissions for machines. We've provided 5 levels of user permissions that can be tracked and logged per user if necessary. And that's really to determine who can change what on a machine, when they changed it, and how they changed any of the settings. Finally, we have a default setting that will time out when someone walks away from a machine to limit changes by unqualified personnel. Let's talk a little bit about the common hardware piece. So the common hardware comes from B&R Automation, who we worked with to integrate their fully scalable and flexible hardware portfolio. And what that means is really the machine application and the performance of the machine determine what hardware it needs. All of the I/O is interchangeable. It uses the same software platform to program. And really what this does is it minimizes the risk and implementation effort for new technologies and protocols moving forward. It streamlines service, spare parts, maintenance. Our service people only have to learn one control platform to better solve our customer problems. And you can use the same I/O pieces. If you have I/O that goes bad, you can change it out at any time. So from a communication standpoint, I mentioned Industry 4.0. All of our machines with touchscreen controls will support OPC UA and other common legacy control protocols moving forward. You'll be able to see and operate the machine control screen remotely via VNC. We will be able to integrate high-speed, long-distance machine networking with plug-in fiber optic modules where necessary. And it will be easier than ever to connect to smart services, which enables powerful reporting, monitoring, and remote control of our machines. We're really excited to get this new HMI and control platform into our customers' plants and move into the next generation of Conair machine control.